G'day YouTube, just dropping a little video for you guys. It's a bit of a tutorial slash a retrospective review of a bit of work I've been doing on this Yahoo from. It's available from Thingiverse, yada yada. There it is, in all its Yahoo glory. And that's all I really wanted to show you of this one. Might just have a quick look at the cross section of it while we're here. Here's one I prepared earlier. Okay, so that's the inside of the frog. There's a little bit of overlapping geometry going on in there. Not a big deal. There he is, yada yada. Moving on to the remix I did of said frog, which is also available on Thingiverse. I'm about to upload the new version with stronger legs shortly. These front legs tended to snap because of the layer lines going across and the nature of the geometry just meant that if you put him down on his front feet, there's a lot of loading right on this point here and it was not suitable. So I have fixed that. I'll have a quick look at that shortly. Number 3 version, where I have joined the feet together. So if you compare those two, there's not a lot of difference visually. What's going on there? Who's asking me to do what? So yeah, we can see there's a bit of a, a bit of a subtle difference there between the two. And in iteration number 3, I've done a few things to that, but we'll get to those in a second. I've also added some little hanger hooks for the feet. Okay, so what's the difference between version 2 and version 3, eh? That's what we need to know. I might just close those other two just because, we'll keep them active. Who knows, why not? Okay, so that one had a little hole in the bum. Alright, so what's inside? No point looking at this one, it's the same as the other. We'll go to these two. What's inside this one? Go to the browser. Look at that. Okay, so there's a lot of geometry going on inside here. When I remixed it, I destroyed the eyes the first time, so I created new ones, and that was the internal geometry of my new eyes. There's a lot going on in there that doesn't need to be. But to keep these tubes here, as you can see, they're all connected, and for the life of me, I couldn't figure out how I could keep the tubes and get rid of the rest of the unnecessary internal geometry, which is just basically made for a smaller planter pot. And I wanted to have as much dirt in there as I could fit. So I've done this. I figured it out. Okay, so I chopped the top off and I did some stuff inside here to make it so that it was all joined up. So I'm about to go in and smooth it over now to make a bit more room, but you can see there's a lot more space if I just lock that steady there and then switch through. Between that version and that one, so there's a lot less space taken up by unnecessary stuff. And if you look at the leg cavity particularly, you get a whole lot more room in there. You've actually got this whole front foot full of dirt now, and the back leg's got a lot more space in it, so there's a lot more room for soil. So I've upped the literage quite a lot, and from the top you look in there, you can't see any difference whatsoever. It is probably doing a few unnecessary print moves around this area though, so I'm going to smooth that out. But what I did was I did a plain cut diagonally through there, and I did a then I sort of looked down on the top and chopped the pieces out of there. So I can't really describe that. I'll actually just have to show you, I guess, won't I? So I'll just duck back to the previous version. Control Shift O brings up the object browser. Get rid of that one. Where's the full one? Not that one. There's another full one. That one do. No, that's a half one. Alrighty. So, what I did was, I might just pause this video and start again now that we're basically starting a new tutorial. So I've shown you the two frogs, I've shown you the difference. You've seen the difference on the bottom of the feet with the hanger hooks. And I'll start now with a little tutorial of how I actually did this last operation. Focus, you mongrel. Alright, there we go. Okay, so this is sort of part two of a little video I just started shooting, and let's get right into it. So I am improving the printability of this piece. I've got quite a few versions of it open up there, let's piss them off. I'll save as here, and I'll call it demo. Alrighty, so I'm going to do a plain cut. Angle. Sorry, the computer's a bit sluggish. You have to forgive the noise of that printer in the background. Alright, so plain cut. Oh, hang on. Controls it. Ah, that's right. Sorry, I actually tell a lie. I did a select because I didn't want to lose those bits of the legs, so I actually selected all. And I made my brush really big. I press Control, and I actually use Symmetry. Painted the legs out so as not to accidentally chop any of them off. That should do it. Edit, plain cut, and I want to choose keep both and remesh fill for this one. Turn that on a bit of an angle. Sorry, my computer's very sluggish. There's about a few versions of the Mesh Mixer open, so it's having a hard time. Nothing more annoying than jerky movements when you're trying to position something. There's so much lag after I actually do something, and then it's between it happening and me doing it, but there we go. Alright, accept that. It's good. So now I need to go to separate shells and green blue do we have sun shells? Alright, so I'm gonna keep one and that one. And hide those two. So I've basically just got the two that I'm using visible. I'm actually going to delete everything else for the purposes of this exercise. Alrighty, there we go. So we've got a top piece and a bottom piece. I'm going to make the top piece, we'll go, just have a quick look at that one first. Okay, so that's the top part. Happy days, yay. Now let's get our bottom part. Alrighty, now I went to the select tool. I double click that purple bit, I press delete to get rid of it. And then we've got this whole internal piece. I now go to selection, edit, separate shells. And there should be two parts if I'm lucky. I can select that and delete it. Buzz, look at that, gone. No more internal crap any of there. All gone, empty, 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 empty. And then I've just got to thicken this by going select, Control A to select it all, edit, offset. Now here's the bit that you want to think, how big is my item and how big am I printing it? Because that is important, and I actually need to double check. I think that I've got it set at 30 centimeters from side to side, or 300 mil. I'll just check that though. So now at this point, I'm deciding how thick I want the walls of my actual real life object to be. Because if I scale this, if I set this so precisely now and then scale my object, it could make all kind of trouble for me. If I try to, for instance, scale it down after I've done this, my walls could end up being paper thin and not print. So what you need to look at is how big am I going to print this version of this object? Because that's sort of relative to what, how thick you want your walls to actually have to print. Otherwise you're going to end up with an unnecessary amount of infill or wasted space or wasted plastic. So I'm really optimizing this. And I want to optimize this little one for 30 centimeters across. The previous version I've optimized for 20 centimeters across from toe to toe. But I've already done that, so I might as well make this one a version that I can use, and I'll actually make him, and I'll also put new foot pegs in him. So I'll just double check. I'm going to cancel that. Sorry about this. I'll just clear that selection. Go into edit and transform. I can have a bit of a peek at the width. So that's 288 across, so it's basically 30 across. I might actually, just for the sake of it, make that 300. Just for the sake of it. Okay, so that's now 300 across. Ooh, hold on a second. I'm not going to do that because I've got this other piece that I've already chopped off. So that would be poor form. Control Z, Control Z, Control Z. I'm going to pause this and just redo that and get back up to the point where I should be, because I don't want to waste your time, peoples. Okie dokie, alright, I believe I'm back to where I should have been up to. So I've just changed the size of that and redone everything back up to that point. And now we're going to look at how we can thicken this bit. So we'll select everything, we'll press Control A. Then we're going to go to Edit and to Offset. And we're going to choose that size that I was talking about. So I want this to print at a thickness that lets me have, well, I'm doing some weird shit. I'm doing some stuff with dual extrusion and they're both two different nozzle sizes. So I'm actually going to calculate my wall thickness for myself, but you guys will need to decide how thick you want your entire wall to be. Now here's where it gets weird. I'm trying to avoid having infill inside my object. The inside of an object is also the outside of an object. and everything's inside out. So basically, it's very confusing, but I want the sum of two walls when I'm looking in my slicer to be the thickness of my entire object thickness for the base part of this. So what I'm getting at is that normally you have one side of an object which has its shell, then you would have infill, and then you would have the other side of an object which has a shell. In this case, I want to put those shells so close together that there's no need for infill in between them, but I'm still going to have to take into account that there is going to be, or want to be, two shells. So I'm going to have one line in the middle and outer line on either side of that, basically. So I'm calculating 0.5 of a mil for my 0.5 mil nozzle, and 0.4, but there's going to be two of those, so that's a total of 0.8 plus 0.5, which is 1 point something or other. I think it's where are we? So 0.5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So I'm going to make my walls 1.3 millimeters thick. Your walls might be different. I'll just work out what a typical one would be. So if you've got a 0.4 mil nozzle, you probably want three walls in total to give you a decent shell of a planter pot, so that you would end up with a total thickness of something like 1.2 mil. Is that right? 4 and 4 is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So that would be 1.2 mil. It's pretty reasonable overall thickness. For a planter pot, you might want it thicker. I don't know. So you need to look at how thick you want your actual planter pot wall to be. And if you want some infill in there, that's fine. That's up to you. But you need to look at how thick you want the actual wall of your object to be, because right here, this is still deemed by the slicer to be the outside of the object, even though it's the inside of the pot. I know that gets confusing, but that's how it is. Say for instance you're looking at a teacup, you don't put the water in the teacup, you're actually technically putting the water on the outside of the teacup when you fill it up with water. Because unless you chip the enamel or the glaze off the outside of the mug and start looking at clay, you're not actually looking inside it. Even with this shape here, that blue there is still technically the outside. If you look at our wireframe, that's all still the outside. It's not until you actually delete something that you start looking at the inside of the stuff, and it is shown in mesh mixer like this. So that's the inside, that's the clay there, so to speak. I'm just going to undo that. So, yeah, that's basically where it gets a little bit confusing. So what you're looking at is the overall wall thickness that you want to have for your object. Is what's important to you, and for me in this case I want to print my frog at 30 centimeters across from toe to toe, between there and there, and I want this wall here to be 1.3 millimeters thick precisely. So that's what I'm going to do, basically, is what I've done there. Now if I was going to scale this down, that wall would get thinner and would end up being too thin, so I wouldn't want to do that. So that's why it's important to sort of think what size you want your final object to be before you start really playing with hollowing things out and making shell thicknesses. Shell thickness is a dangerous word there. I guess I could say object thicknesses or something, because if you're talking in slicer, the shell is only one of these walls, whereas I'm kind of referring to the shell just then as being the overall thing. So it's a bit dangerous when you start talking about that sort of stuff. So I hope you're all following and on the same page. Now it's basically just a case of getting that and that and sticking them together. Now I tried a few different ways, and the only way that seemed to work for me was to select them both. Why have I still got a selection tool? Select both, combine, make solid, and I've just learned about offsets, and they're lovely. So yeah, you sort of get this, and previously all I could really know how to do was to choose accurate, crank up the solid accuracy all the way and the mesh density a fair way, You can go all the way too, but it just gets bulky and slow. Now that'll take a little while. I might just pause that. Okay, good stuff that's done. It's worked. Now, here's the ugly bit. See that little groove down there? Not cool, right? Not what we wanted. And that was the bane of my existence for a fair while, because I didn't know how the hell to stop that. Turns out it's offset. Not 0.3 seemed to do it before. Update. I'm going to pause that again for you guys, because it takes ages. Basically that's done, and where was I up to? I've walked away and come back. I've lost my train of thought. Pretty cool looking frog, isn't he? There was we. Ah, that's right. We're just done to make solid, and that should have fixed it. I'll just click accept. Yeah, there's no big ugly scar down there anymore. That's good. Happy days. Get rid of the wireframe. Just have a look at it. Smooth. 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 That's what we like to see. Accept. Okay, so now, where was it up to? So we've got, what's this object here going on? Ah, the underneath one before we made it solid. Alright, we can delete that. Go back to our solid. Alright, we've got a smooth frog that's now got less crack inside. Let's just have a little peek inside into the plane cut. Edit. Plane cut. Slice through both sides, and if you want to put something back together again, don't do fill. Seems? Although, now that I know that little trick with the thingo, maybe it won't be such a big deal. Yeah, it seems my symmetry is a little bit off kilter. Interesting. I might just do one thing, just hold on a second. Cancel the plane cut. I'm just going to click a line. See if that makes it better or worse. Normally that plane cut goes right down the middle. Keep both. No fill, except. Yeah, it's a pretty kinky little program, MeshMix. There's a lot of little funny things about it that you just need to know, I guess. I still haven't worked out quite what the go is with the symmetry stuff. Sometimes things are in the middle and sometimes they're not. And when you align things, it's got to be something to do with pivots or something. I don't get it. Anyway, I'm going to now separate shells and I'm really sorry about the noise of the printer in the background. It's just the limitations of my space. Alright, now I've just hidden one of those sides. That is now my object. Okay. It's a lot less crap in there, isn't it? Much more room for plants and things, just like there was in the other one. But I don't have the footholes in there yet. And what else did I want to do? I wanted to actually do some smoothing inside here. I'm sort of not really quite happy. Let's get rid of the object browser for a minute. I'm not really quite happy with this very sudden 90 degreeness here. Now, all I can think to do here is deal with this in two attempts. So I'm going to go to the select tool. I'm going to choose the unwrap brush, so I'm only selecting what I'm sort of seeing. Ooh, that's dangerous, man. I just need that little bit there off. Oh, that's hard to control. Very hard to control. I'm going to make my brush a bit smaller. Basically, I'm just going to select that whole area along there. Just see what happens when I get it with the smooth tool. I'll just do that patch for now. Deform. Smooth. Crank that smoothing up. And see if we've trashed anything on the outside of anything. Ooh, hang on, what have we done there? Why the hell has it done that? Alright, let's try it. Hold on a second. I know what's going on. For some reason I had the symmetry tool selected and that has actually selected that other patch. That's why it's done all that weird stuff to it. That makes sense. Trim that up a little bit. So ideally we can make this shape here a lot smoother. And I should have done this. I should have gone and modify optimized boundary, which does not much, and then modify smooth boundary, which does more. I should have done that. And then when I go to smooth, it would have been better. Crank up that smoothing scale. Alright, that's looking better. Don't see any difference on the outside. Now that inside is going to be a lot more printable, I believe, because it's not going to have any sudden 90 degree overhangs. Except, now, I'm going to do the same thing to the other part. Control Shift O. Uh oh. Battery low. Give me a sec. Okay, so sorry, I said pause that. So battery changing over, and I've lost my train of thought again. So now I've gone back to my object browser, Control Shift O to bring that up, and now I'm going to basically just switch the visibility and my selection, and then go back in and do that other side. Same thing. So select tool, select the part you wish to smooth. Man, it would be good to have a faster computer because this is still glitchy as. I think maybe I need a better monitor actually. Might be the case. Because I'm not plugged in through the right ear, I don't think. Anywho. Should do it. Modify. I don't exactly know what optimized boundary does. It does not much, but it seems to make a little bit of a difference. So I'll just do it. And smooth boundary. In this case, I'm going to just drop the preserve shape down a lot. And smoothness up a lot. And then... I'll make it as smooth as I can, go to defaults for a second. What have I done? Minimal preserve shape. We don't care about the shape that we're drawing. We want maximum smoothness. I think more iterations maybe. Yeah, that'll do. whatevs. Alright, let's make that smoother and do the form and smooth and crank up the smoothing scale. Check on the outside for damages. I'm pretty sure it's bringing it all inwards. We'll check by pattern and a half in a little bit. Accept that, I'm happy. Clear selection, select parts, buzz buzz. We've selected everything, we're going to combine, and then we're going to close cracks once they're combined. Alrighty, now that we've closed our cracks, we're going to cut them in half again. I've already done this, so I'm just going to do it again. No, I should have just used the redo button. Anyway, I don't mind doing it again. Righto, so we're going to chop his ass off. We're going to choose no fill, we're going to accept. We're going to jump straight back in, we're going to do another plain cut. We're going to chop off his face. See, this is the good thing about doing things twice, you get to do it differently. I'm going to rotate that sucker, because before I only did the bum and then I got to a standstill anyway, where I had to chop the face off anyway, so I might as well do it at the same time. Alright, time for a little face-off. Hopefully that's good. Hit both parts. No fill. Accept. Separate shells. We're going to hide this big bit in the middle here so that we don't see it, and that will make life easier for us, because now we can get in there and we can do the inside of the... I've cut that a bit fine. I'm just going to move that last plane cut back a little bit. I need a bit more space to work on his head there. Just give myself a little bit more wiggle room. Yeah, that's better. Basically, I'm just trying to get back to the point where I'm past this yucky bit here. We'll accept that. Separate shells again. No multiple shells found, my ass. Okay, so there's going to be a whole lot of fingers and toes and things chopped off there. It doesn't matter. I'm going to go to that and hide it. And just double check that I can get good access to everything. Yep, good-o. Good-o. Alright, let's just get his rear end sorted out first. Alrighty, select, modify, smooth boundary, accept, and deform smooth, crank up the smoothing scale. You can probably even do more, but that looks pretty smooth to me. Accept. Clear selection. Look at that. Beautiful. Well done. Now the trick is to stay away from... Oh, there's nothing there. Hang on a second. Control Shift O for object browser. Control Shift O. Let's bring everything back and we'll hide what we want to hide this time. Just hide that. And then hide his bum. Two parts of his bum. So the reason you don't know, I don't know if I mentioned this already, or in this version of the video anyway, but the cracks, do not go near those cracks when you're editing after the fact, while you've got them cut open, or they will be different when you go to stick them back together and they won't stick. It's basically the gist. Now, oh crikey. Rockies, hang on. Nah, that's a pain. Alright, this is going to be a pain. Let's see how we go. Select. I'll put symmetry on and see if it gives me any joy. Why is that symmetry plane so crap, right? If this ever happens to you guys, you can just move it. It's just a pain in the ass. I don't know why it's like it. Ever since I did something to it, it's gone wacky. And I don't think that was in the middle before either. Really, to be honest. Let's have a look at his face. Alright, that's my next little project, is working out what the hell's going on with the symmetry plane on me. But anyway, for now that'll probably do. It's just a bit of a general guide to help me select a bit more evenly. I've screwed it up. Anyway, we'll see how I go. Just to make the selecting process a little bit faster, a little bit more even. Now, keep in mind when you're selecting like this, you don't want to have the ball tool that selects as a ball. You want to have the tool that selects not as a ball. When it's just a disc. Or a, I call it the unwrap brush. If you've got the ball, you're going to penetrate through to the other side and select stuff on the outside of the model, which is not what you want to be doing. Alrighty, now I'm going to try all that smooth business and just hope for the best here, because what may happen is it may not like the amount of geometry that it's got to try and smooth. So we shall see. Might not even like the smoothie boundary. Yep, just done that. Good-o. Alright, that's a good sign. Deform. Smooth. Come on, you. Puff up, puff up. Puff up beautifully. How much can you smooth? You can smooth, apparently. What's going on down there? We've got some loss of something. She's busting through. I'm going to try something. I'm just going to say that normally I wouldn't, but I've learned something recently. The soft transform. That may get me out of trouble here. We'll just see what happens if I just pull that back a little bit with the soft transform. Oh, it's not looking good. Okay, forget that. Are you going to cancel? Yep, alright. What I might do is I might clear the selection and then select again. See if I can't do a. Let's get rid of symmetry and do them one at a time, I think. See if I can't just fix those bits by themselves. You mongrel. Okay, I'm going to work something out. I'll get back to you shortly, people. Alrighty, I'm back to before I actually clicked smooth, or before I clicked go on the smooth. That's my selection. Now I'm going to clear that selection. And I'm going to start again by just selecting this bit here by itself. For now, rather than that whole other patch, let's just make sure I haven't selected anything on the outside. Try that. Modify, optimize boundary. It did something then. Modify smooth boundary. Set. It's new and smooth. Deform smooth. Let's smooth the crap out of that bit and see if it wrecks anything. You know what we can actually do is delete that bit. Let's have a look in there. Oh, look at that, beautiful. Alright, let's try something different. Let's try the selection analysis inspector. Where is your inspector, Mr. Hole? Not that one. Oh, you. Okay, this is a little bit odd. I'm just going to try some things. What this should do is, there should be a blue line coming up here, and there's not. So I'm a little bit baffled. Maybe this one here is supposed to be pointing to the back end of it. So I'm just clicking it. I'm going to probably just straight away click undo, and then click the other one, because there's only two of them. And I'll just do a little bit of investigation there. I'm just going to pause it while it does this. It's taking a while. Okay, it's still going. That's a big operation for some reason. Probably shouldn't have done it. I'll keep you paused and keep you posted. Okay, just as I suspected, it's filled something and I didn't want it filled in, so Control Z. And now the good thing about that is that that's going to have the... Okay, that's weird. Forget about that. Cancel the inspector. Control Z, get out of there. Go back into edit. Just undo that deletion, and we might just go with the F instead. I don't know why I didn't think of that before. We'll see what happens there. Fill. Ah, bullets. Look at that. Why didn't I think of that? Alright, so that's the fill function. So I've just basically deleted and filled that, which is what the inspector should have been able to have patched up. I don't know why I didn't think to use the fill function, but there it is. So that's just by pressing F with the selection. It will delete and then fill that part with the... just so you can see where I select the thing. You had to go to edit fill if you didn't want to use your hotkeys. If you want to do things the dumb way, you can do them this way. You can go edit and erase and fill, and it says there F. So you basically, anytime you want to erase and fill or you've got a selection selected, just press F and it will do it. In the name of the game of removing unnecessary detail, one can press F and buzz. As you can see, unnecessary detail, gone. Gone skis. Probably could have done that in the in a few of the other cases as well, instead of choosing smooth, but would have probably done virtually the same thing. But yeah, there we go. That's pretty cool. There's still a little bit more I can do there. Now, just increase that. Let's accept that. And then I'm going to expand my little selection. around to there. Sometimes it's good to just do things bit by bit. Hello. Default, oh, whoops, and modify. Optimize the boundary, which has done nothing. Default, no modify, smooth boundary, which will hopefully smooth it up a bit, except. Kind of just makes more triangles around the edges of things as well, like. Oh, maybe not. I thought it did. Anyway, it definitely makes a nice clean cut there, whereas the other one, it cuts new triangles in half, for sure, because those lines are nice and smooth. Anyway, we're now going to... Well, let's just see what happens if we hit the F button here. That was pretty good. Ooh, I like it. Let's have a look from the outside and see if it F'd anything. No, everything is intact. Alright, nothing is effed. Alright, that's very smooth, very happy. Very, very nice. Very nice, very, very nice. Alright, I like it. That's pretty good. There's still a bit of unnecessary stuff going on in there, so we'll accept that, and then we'll clear the selection. And we'll get in there and we'll make another selection. This time I'm just going to mold my brush a little bit. I'm just going to just go, see if we can't take out, this is going to introduce a bit of infill, but I think that having these shells a little bit further apart is only going to be a bonus. Unselect a bit of that. Just see if that's worth doing. I'll just do it with an F to start with. Oh, that's pretty good. But it's pretty good. But I'll undo that and I'll try it with modify, optimize boundary, modify smooth boundary. I'm going to start doing that with O and B by now as well. Okay, happy with that. Okay, and now what happens if I press F? I think that's a bit better. So we'll go with that. Check from the outside, and I think that is going to print nicer because it's just going to be cleaner, smoother lines, less jerking around, and I think it'll be a bit happier for all concerned. Realistically, we can probably actually take out that dimple in the back of the eyeball anyway as well. To do so is a bit slow, modify, optimize boundary. Why is it taking a while? Maybe it's not going to happen then. That's what I wanted to fill. Might expand that boundary a little bit more. Boom. Alright, that's better. I think that's going to print easier. Less weird stuff going on. I think, I don't know, maybe not. We'll see. Accept that, and do some more smoothing, and go. I'm not going to bother smoothing the boundaries. I think just hitting F seems to be working pretty well there, really. Boom. Set. Through selection, we select. So I'm probably dragging this out a little bit, but let's just see what happens if we just smooth all that off there. Is that more printable? I think yes. I don't know, maybe that's a better way to do it. I don't know. Just undo all of that. Let's select all of this. Big smooth area that we select. So the name of the game here is to make it print as efficiently as possible. And sometimes I reckon if you can just get rid of some zigzaggy detail and crap, even if you make something a little bit bigger, sometimes you can use less material and print it easier. Okay, so we'll try the optimized boundary business here because we want to make it as good as we can. Smooth boundary. Set, smooth enough. Deform. What do we want to do? Do we want to smooth that on the F? Do we want to fill? And then we want to make our bulge go boom. How much does it need to before? Okay, so it's touching there. It's probably as much as we need there. Does that print better than that? A lot less zigzagging around. It's going to be a much cleaner line on the way around through there. Now, let's just cut a cross section of that and have a look. As the printer would view it. As the printer would see it. And cut. You kind of get yourself a printer's eye view and snip this wireframe off. A bit distracting trying to see through all that, but we'll get there. Alrighty, so we had a little bit of drama with the camera cutting out again. It stops every 25 minutes and I've got to pay attention to that. And I'll probably edit all this out, but I may just get lazy and slap some bits together and make you watch it all too. So we'll see what happens there. But I've selected this bit, I've done the other side, I've decided I'm going to do the same thing here. Modify, smooth boundary. You guys are going to get used to that, aren't you? Accept. Deform. No, I'm not smoothing. We're effing. We're filling. And we're going to make our bulge stick out like we like to do. So we like to stick our bulges out. That'll do. Accept. And that's looking pretty slick. Clear selection. And I think it's time to probably do a little bit more smoothing around those edges. So if I now circle around there, might be able to do all this at once, we'll just see. We'll see if it likes it. Basically just gonna put a pair of sunnies on it. Selecting those bits, I don't think. Hopefully this works, now that you've watched me do all that. Alright, we'll go through and try our smooth boundary business again. I'll just do a bit of a plain line across there. So it's really good to have your symmetry buddy working properly. A bit of luck, that's just going to work. Arr, why is that happening? Ah, because of stupid symmetry. Right, we won't be using symmetry. I'm going to see that right here. Do it the hard way. Alright, let's try that again. Optimize boundary. Smooth boundary, please like it. Yes, it likes it. Accept. Deform. Smooth. How far can we smooth it before it starts to screw things up? I don't think it's going. I think it's all going to smooth inwards and it might be happy days. That's pretty smooth. I'll accept that. Time just to get that little bit that I missed. Smooth that again. I don't know if it'll make much difference to the rest of the stuff that was already smooth or not. Let's just double check that. That's definitely made an improvement there. Doesn't seem to have wrecked anything. Nothing much damage from it. Oh, hang on, what have we got here? Let's find the first time. Let's just leave it at that there. Clear that selection, make a freshie. Smooth the boundary, got the rough way, just smoothing. Bump it on, the farm, smooth. Smoothing the scale, crank that up, accept. Alright, now that is smooth. That is smooth. Alright, we're happy with that. I don't know why the hell it's got all that stuff going on there, but it does. I don't think any of it's going to matter. No, that's all fine. Alright, nothing has been damaged near our joins. I think we're all ready to stick everything back together again. Did I fix the bum? Select everything, combine. Close cracks. And we should have one homogeneous thing. Alright, that's looking pretty cool. I shall now just do a plain cut. Have a bit of a flippy flippy. Oh man, that object browser gets in the way big time. That looks a lot faster at painting that inside curve there, don't you reckon? There's no jerking around all that stuff, so now it's only going to do the complex stuff on the outside of the shape, and then the inside is going to be nice and smooth and simple for it to print. I really think that this is going to make a very big difference to the quality of this print and how fast it prints. Should be much happier printing. Alright, so now the only thing left to do is cancel that. There's two things I want to do. One of them is go to Mesh Mix. I've got some pre-made parts that I've made here. This is the critical one. I'm going to slap that on there. I'm going to tell it to be a Boolean subtract. I'm going to position it on his palm, and I'm going to just bring the offset back to there somewhere. Accept that, and that should punch a nice neat little hole in his hand. So I just made that part by just putting shapes together and then did a make solid on it to make it smooth. And give it lots of triangles so that it meshes well with things and is good for Boolean subtracts. And we have a nice neat little hole in the hand that can hang in different directions, so you can hang in on different stuff. So obviously there's more of them to come. Buzz. 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 I'll do a few more of those. That armpit looks a bit ugly. We could fix that, but it looks at armpits. Again, that could print faster. that's from where I bent the arm to join it under here, and I haven't sort of taken the time to fix everything right up. Let's mix another one of these guys on. It's very handy to have those parts. So these will also act as drainage holes obviously as well, so that'll be another bonus. See, if I can be bothered, I could probably pull out all these loading times and make things nicer for you guys. We'll just see how many likes I get with it as it is. If enough people are watching it and it's worth my while, I might start doing some editing. Otherwise, I'll just try and keep it interesting in the wait time by talking shit. It's important to... In this case, the reason I'm doing that is just because I want to make sure that it doesn't punch through the top of the foot, so I'm doing that offset. The reason I'm doing them all over the place is just to give people a choice which way they want to hang it. So I'm thinking even with the bottom, I'm going to do two, because I don't want people being stuck with only being able to hang it straight up and down. They might want to hang it on a bit of a weird kilter, with a weird angle. So I'll put a few in, and some extra drainage holes isn't going to hurt. I don't know whether I'm saving any time or plastic here, I might be wasting a bit of time with them, but... Actually, I can probably get rid of two of those, realistically. It's going to take a while to get rid of them though, so I won't worry about that. We'll just see. In the future, I might have a few less. And there we have it. Hanging frog, marble hanging options. You can pretty much just hang him on whichever one of those you want by just one, or you can hang him by two if you want him to hang parallel, vertical and dead straight. But I would imagine that being a frog, it's probably going to be nicer sitting on a bit of an organic twist, so any of those hooks with one hook will hang on a different orientation, and it should be happy days. Okay, so now to save it, I'm going to go save as standard front pot will do for now. Okay, and I'm also going to export that. I'm actually going to override, I won't override it, I'll just write it smooth. Okay, so, that's done. We'll just bring it into the slicer. And I've got a whole bunch of these other videos open. Versions open, so you can see there, that was our original. I'm going to close that without making any changes, saving any changes. I'm going to close that sucker without saving any changes. It's that version that didn't have a feature on together. I'll close that sucker without saving any changes. Back to my desktop. Pop into Cura. Not quite sure what version of this. Oh, this is just the stronger from Pot with the basic bottom, and I'll just prepare that so you can have a quick look at it. So that's currently at a smaller size as well, it's a 200 previous version of the pot. That's this guy. Okay, so just looking at the layer view, you can see this is the version that I had done some work to reduce the size of the thickness of the sides, but I've still got this square horrible bit here printing up, which I think is wasting a bit of time. So we'll just sort of have a little, that's going to not be making a fair comparison if I use this same frog here, because it's 200, so it won't be a fair size comparison, speed comparison, but I'm just going to start a new project. Yes, I do want to put in a build plate. Open file. Okay, so 200 frog pot smooth. Prepare. Okay, so I'll have a quick look at the layer view and just see how that looks like it's going to print up. Okay, that's a much smoother shape there. That inside curve is just going to fly around that corner, whereas before it would have been. So now that should be a lot smoother. Yes, there's going to be some infill, but that should be fairly fast. Hopefully this saves me time. It's still going to take 1 day and 2 hours. It's not a fast print at this size. And it's going to use a total of 14 dollars worth of plastic. But I still think that's pretty good. I think that's a decent decent rendition of this print. So it's giving us plenty of space inside there. Should print up pretty well. Thank you, Dave. Alright, well, I'm going to actually save that shortly. Actually, what I will do is I'm going to switch printers. I'm actually getting it ready for my CR10, not my T-Rex. So I'll have to then slice that again. I was pretty happy with that last profile. And this isn't going to want to fit on the build plate in this orientation. load up there. No, it's rotating a bit more. Come on, you can fit on there. Why couldn't Kira figure that one out for itself? Alright, there we go. Loaded. Prepare. And it's going on the card. Okay, thank you for watching.